So, like, when you get done, can you call me so you can come over and do that?
Wait, why?
Because I need to pack the hospital bag tonight.
Well, then just pack it.
Yeah, but I want you to be here.
No.
I'll be damned if I'm pregnant and the man I'm pregnant by does not want to help me pack the hospital bag for his own baby. I'd be enraged. I hope that man get a motherfucking staff. Because how dare you? What would be the point of me coming over there? Excuse you? The point is, child. And this is why teenagers shouldn't be having babies. This is why babies shouldn't be having babies. The relationships don't last. The emotional maturity just isn't there. Okay? Like, it just doesn't make any sense. Today, we are going to be reacting to a TLC show called Unexpected. We're gonna also be talking about the glorification of teen pregnancy and teen parenting, because this actually has been on my list for a very, very long time. But then somebody sent me this, and I was just like, and I've been hooked on the show. If you guys have not watched Unexpected on TLC, basically 16 and Pregnant 2.0. These kids are ruining their lives and they don't even understand it yet. Miss Ami, comment down below if you have watched Unexpected on TLC. This shit just makes me want to pull my goddamn locks out. It's a lot going on in this show, okay? I'm very sure a lot of you guys have seen other YouTubers react to the whole the worst couple on the internet. There's another couple that was on here a previous season that basically was talking about, I want to get my noodle wet. And it was the same couple that was sitting here like literally talking about how they got pregnant, but then he was talking to the girl's best friend and got her pregnant. Y'all, this show is crazy. So I decided to watch it for myself, and I was just like, ooh, child, the ghetto. So of course, like I said, I'm gonna be talking about the glorification of teen pregnancy, and I'm also gonna be reacting to this video. Lots of pauses. If you guys don't care for my input, I'm gonna link it down below. But of course, before we get started, smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, smash everybody, you know, that can help a sister out. If you guys want a one-on-one consultation, you guys can schedule one via my company, Media Hustle. Make sure you guys join the close, the Facebook group for creators only, where I do post regular advice on there. I also have a Instagram group where I post regularly tips for your YouTube channel. I'm going to be doing lives on the Facebook group where you guys can ask me questions as well for your channel. And also make sure you guys just check the description box regularly so you guys can see what's going on, because you guys always ask me all these questions. I'm like, guys, just check the description box. And there's too many of y'all that be watching these videos and you don't leave a comment. What are you doing? Leave a comment. Thank you. Thank you. I don't mean to yell. Leave a comment. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup. Alright, so let me just say right now, there's a lot going in this. And when it comes to the whole teen pregnancy thing, it just really grinds my gears. These people are so young, and it's weird because, like, when you're this age, you don't see it that way. You think you know it all, but, like, you don't know shit. So let's get straight to the reaction. I'm giving my commentary throughout. So grab your tea, grab your snacks, grab your vape, grab whatever you need, because it's gonna be a lot. Let's get straight into it.
My name is Emily, I'm 18, and I'm 37 weeks pregnant. When I found out I was pregnant, I kept telling myself, like, I'm gonna wake up and everything's gonna be okay. Like, this is not happening to me. This stuff doesn't happen to me. I had just got cheer captain. I was varsity softball player. You know, the reality hit me that I was pregnant when I took the test.
And this is the thing, right? Like I said, when you're a teenager, you really don't think about any of this shit. You just be young and wild and free. Okay, you don't think about all this shit, right? You just be living your life. And it's crazy because I come from a background where, like, I was mainly fighting. I was fighting for my life, because you guys know I'm Haitian. I come from a place where being Haitian where I was from was dangerous. So it was like all my life I had to fight. Fight downstairs, a fight upstairs, a fight on the east wing, fight. Like, it was a lot. It was mainly fighting, but of course there was pregnant people too. There was kids with tattoos. There was a lot going on. So it was a lot of, like, mental anguish that I was going through. And funny enough, I was actually one of those kids that wanted to be pregnant. Don't. Y'all probably like, Ivana, don't. Yes, bitch. I see so many kids, right, getting dragged on Twitter for saying shit, or like tweets resurfacing because like someone said something when he was 16. And it's like, I never really say anything, only because it's like, if the person's like 16, 15, 14, I was a volatile ass teen. Just the fact of thinking that I wanted a kid when I was like fucking 15, 16 is crazy, because I'm 27 now and I'm like, why did I want to be a teen mom? I just thought I would have someone that loved me and depended on me. For whatever reason, I just felt like no one loved me, no one cared for me. When you're a child, when you're a teenager, your mind is not fully developed and you make really rational decisions and really impulsive decisions. Was I ever trying to get pregnant? Absolutely not. But it was one of those things that I just hoped would happen. So every time like I would like get a little boyfriend or have a little crush, I would always be like, oh my God, this is gonna be the father of my child. So that's when I kind of stopped fucking with hood niggas and like stopped fighting. And do guys, you guys are probably like, girl, any guy that I mess with has to be suitable enough to like be my baby father. I kid you not. Funny enough, I had friends that actually tried to and were successful. I had friends that wanted to have kids, but a lot of kids aren't trying to. This is accidental. Like this girl, she was an all-star athlete. She wasn't trying to, she just got pregnant. And it's crazy because there's girls that go through this, they get abortions, some don't, some have miscarriages. So it's like, it's weird because regardless if you're trying to or not, you're not mentally prepared for it. It's an entire life commitment. It's not, oh, you only have to take care of the kid till the kid's 18. No, it's a whole life commitment. So I'm like, yeah, I'd rather not. So it's like, if I'm not 100% committed to that experience for the rest of my life, I just would rather not. I'd rather not bring kids into the world if I'm not ready to commit to it for the rest of my life. But back in the day, I was very, very like, don't kill the babies. I understand people that are still like that because I was very like that back in the day. But it's so interesting because it's like, you're not the same person as a teenager versus who you are when you become an adult or where your brain is fully developed. So it's just so interesting to see these shows now, because like when I used to watch 16 and Pregnant, I just used to watch it. 16 and Pregnant kind of really changed my mind. But I feel like 16 and Pregnant glorified teen pregnancy. I don't know what it was, like something about the way they filmed the show. And it was like at the end where they would have that little snippet of, yeah, I would never wish this, it's so hard. And it was like, what the fuck? I don't know. It was something about the way they filmed the show that made it glorify it. This right here, it really showcases the hardships way more, so.
When I first found out I was pregnant, the last person I wanted to tell was my mom, because I knew how disappointed she was gonna be.
Not once have I told you I was disappointed because of it.
Yeah.
No, I haven't.
You should.
It was just Emily and I. Emily was my best friend, and the thought of her having a baby just seems unreal.
Baby daddy. He had to take a test at school.
I'm Diego, I'm 17, and I'm gonna be a dad.
All I'd ever done was kiss a guy. And I was Diego's first girlfriend, first kiss, first everything.
The first woman I had intercourse with.
Oh my God.
And we were planning on saving until the marriage, but it kind of took a left turn somewhere around there.
So let me just explain this right here. So he seems a little sweet, a little wholesome right there. If you guys ever watched the show, I actually watched this entire season. This is, I believe, season 2 of Unexpected. This boy is such a dick. Like I said, these are kids. What the hell do you expect from like fucking 16, 17, 18 year olds? No, this boy's mean. I'm talking about like literally cursing out the mom, being very, very rude, being very disrespectful to authority, to adults. Like he's very mean. He's very mean to her. He's not catering to her. He's not there, to the point where when the baby is finally born, he does not know how to properly prepare the baby's bottle. That's how much he's not there. Okay, so I had to spoil it for y'all, for those of you guys who didn't watch the show, but I'm sure a lot of you guys didn't watch the show. Like, this boy is just not prepared. But again, what do you expect from a child? Like, and it's really frustrating because his parents don't seem to give a fuck for his behavior. Bridget, the girl's mom, is trying to kind of like intervene and trying to get him to care, but he doesn't necessarily care. And this is where the whole teen pregnancy problem arises, right? You see how she's kind of like trying to keep a level head, like, oh, I never said I was disappointed. Yeah, you should've, okay? Like, this is the problem I have with people in this whole teen pregnancy thing and the whole trying to cater to teenagers when they do bad shit. I understand you don't want to upset your teenager. I understand, yeah, she's pregnant, but at the end of the day, she did something wrong. She needs to know that she did something fucking wrong. Why would you not want to tell her you're disappointed? You're disappointed. She did something disappointing. What's she gonna do, cry? Okay, and get over it. She did something that was wrong. It is what it is. On top of that, she's with a sleaze bag. I don't know if they're gonna show it in this little snippet, but this boy is ridiculously mean to this girl. And then on top of that, his parents do do not rectify his behavior. He's sitting here calling the mom a motherfucker on camera. Like, it's bad. But again, they're kids. And it's sad because it seems like a lot of parents seem to tiptoe around a situation because they don't really know what to do. It's kind of sad because it's like, what do you do when your teen ends up in this situation? Like, personally, I'd be sick.
For a while, Emily and Diego's relationship seemed fine. But then over time, I just kind of noticed that he kind of was rude and kind of belittling not only to Emily, but to everyone around him.
Well, he didn't treat me like that at first.
I really never thought she was going to be pregnant at all because she used to tell me, I'm not messing all this up.
I told you that once when I was like 12.
She wasn't going to have sex until she was married.
Yeah, but we had never talked about sex, ever.
Very interesting. So she said she was going to save herself for marriage, but they never talked about sex. Parents, if you're watching this, please stop avoiding the whole sex talk with your kids. I understand it's awkward, but like when your kids don't know what happens and they don't know the extent of like their sexual organs, this is what happens. They end up pregnant at 16, 17, 18. Or just way before their time. I feel like a lot of parents have this whole philosophy of school will teach them, they'll find out along the way, their friends will teach them, they'll find out some way. Do you really want your kids to find out from strangers, from different people, from the outside world? Do you really want another man, another woman to teach your kid about sex and then some shit like this happens? I literally had parents literally call me to teach their kids about sex and I'm like, why do I have to do this? When they don't know, they get curious and they go searching and they go finding things that they shouldn't find. She kind of knew already. She still wasn't. I'm not gonna get, you know, I'm not about to mess all of this up at 12. So she already knew. But it's like, if she already knew, you could have kind of like sat her down. Like, she knew something. You could
talk about your period all the time.
Yeah, I talk about period, but we never talked about sex.
Okay, we usually want you to wait about 2 weeks.
The
reason for that is the uterus can be still be pretty big and wobbly.
That's good, because I'm trying out for cheer.
Cheerleader?
Yeah, I'm trying to get ready for it.
The unrealistic expectations. This is the thing, right? When it comes to the whole parenting thing when you're young, I feel like a lot of teenagers or just very young parents, because I even had this whole situation happen with my friend when she was pregnant when we were in college. I feel like a lot of them have unrealistic expectations. Y'all be thinking, oh yeah, when I'm done having this baby, I'm gonna like go back to my regular life. She really thinks she's about to be able to juggle a baby, a newborn at that, with going to college and being a cheerleader, bitch, where being able to work out like literally 2 weeks after having a baby is gonna be extremely hard, especially after her first baby. How about if she ends up having a cesarean? And then on top of that, it's just the lack of sleep she's gonna have to deal with, just the stress of it all. How about she ends up having postpartum, God forbid? But it's like, it's so many things that she's not taking into account. I don't think she's thinking about the fact that clearly her baby father's trash, so I'm sure he's not gonna be able to help. Your mom has her own life and she's a little bit older. It's a lot of things that people don't take into account, especially when you're a kid. You're thinking, oh, okay, well, yeah, I have friends, I have family, and that's another thing. A lot of people forget, and a lot of people don't take into account, when you're pregnant at a young age like that, your friends leave you. They do not fuck with you anymore. And it's not, usually it's not even on purpose, it's that they can't relate to you anymore, right? Like when you're 18, from 18 to 25-ish, everybody's in the club. Everybody's going to parties, they going to prom, they going to college parties. Everybody's out, they living their best life. They worried about girl trips. They're not worried about babies. You're pregnant. You can't go nowhere. You have a baby at home. So it's not as if they're intentionally like, oh, that bitch pregnant, we can't call her. It's, oh, she's pregnant, she's busy. So slowly you start to drift away from people's minds. It's not intentional that they forget about you, but it just, they forget about you. Okay, well, of course there's childcare. Boy, with what money? Childcare could be literally the cheapest, maybe $1,000 a month. And who has $1,000 a month to show your baby to someone to watch? It's hard. It's not as easy as a lot of people think.
Can you come over? We just got back home.
When I first met Emily, we were at a junior high football game.
And we started talking.
Our first conversation.
It did not go well.
Was about horses. How much I hate horses.
And I was like, this guy, yeah, no.
Definitely did not see myself having a baby like my junior year of high school. I'm slightly terrified of what is to come when the baby is here.
So, like, when you get done, can you call me? So you can come over and do that?
Wait, why?
Because I need to pack the hospital bag tonight.
Well, then just pack it.
Yeah, but I want you to be here.
No.
I'll be damned if I'm pregnant and the man I'm pregnant by does not want to help me pack the hospital bag for his own baby. I'd be enraged. I hope that man get a motherfucking star. Because how dare you? What would be the point of me coming over there? Excuse you? The point is, oh, child. And this this is why teenagers shouldn't be having babies. This is why babies shouldn't be having babies. The relationships don't last. The emotional maturity just isn't there. Okay? Like, it just doesn't make any sense. This shit don't make no sense to me. And this is, I guess, around the part where you start to see how much of an asshole he is. And just for context, the girl throughout this entire series basically makes the excuse for him. Oh, you know, when we're alone, he's a lot nicer. But as you guys can see, they're alone. Well, I mean, over the phone, and he's still being an asshole to her. And it's so sad because, you know, throughout the series, she basically starts to kind of cut off her mom and kind of goes towards him because apparently her mom is like emotionally abusive and is very controlling over her. I think both her mom and him are kind of narcissistic in a way, or have narcissistic traits. Let me not say they're narcissistic, because narcissism is actually a real mental illness. I'm not a mental health professional to say that. They have like very, very territorial type of traits, and they're pretty dominant over her, and she's kind of like, she doesn't know what to do. She wants to be with her boyfriend, I guess, so her child could have a father, but at the same time, you know, that's her mom. Wherever they are, she need to move away from them, because they're both not good for her. They're both pretty toxic.
I feel like Diego and I are just drifting apart from each other. We're not the same as we used to be.
Nigga, y'all was never close.
He's actually gonna love his daughter. But at the same time, I feel like he's gonna be a father on his own time and when he wants to be a father. I want it to matter to him.
Why need to discuss it with me?
Because you have to like be a part of it and stuff. I don't want him just to come into my daughter's life when he wants and when he chooses. His rude comments and his rude actions and putting other stuff before his daughter hurt me.
And that's what's gonna happen if you let it happen. And this is the reality that a lot of teen parents go through. Like, a lot. Shit, a lot. And it's crazy because a lot of that has to do with sexism, right? Most of the time, these boys know these babies are theirs. But the problem here is, yeah, that's my baby, but technically you have to take care of it. I can do what the fuck I want. And what really makes me mad is a lot of these parents do not bear the responsibility of making their sons take responsibility for what they've done and the mess that they've created. This is where you'll see a lot of them sit there like, oh, I want a paternity test. That's not my son's baby. Oh, well, my son has a football career and, you know, he's going to school. That's why she's saying that's his baby. Oh, well, she's the whore and she lured my son to do this. Oh, well, she's literally trying to pin a baby on him because he has an amazing career. Oh, he's going to be a rapper. This is where you see all of that shit comes in, where you see these men just do whatever the fuck it is that they want because technically they can, okay? We see these men relinquish their parental rights, whether they're 18 or 48. That's your baby. It came from you. You have the maternal right. You have that maternal instinct to guide this child, to take care of this child. I'm just the father. I don't give a fuck. I don't like your attitude. I don't want to take care of this baby. And it's worse when their parents are enabling their behavior, when their parents are justifying their behavior, when their parents are sitting there like, oh, well, you don't have to take care of that child. She's a whore anyway. It's so sad. And I don't even think that these people come to realize the fuck up that they do until they're literally like adults. Until they're like literally 68 and they try to find their kid. And their kid wants nothing to do with them anymore because they literally denied them for so long. Okay? They stopped caring about them. All you had to do was see the kid every year at least. Give them a little birthday present. At least say that you're the kid's parent. You know, kids don't necessarily even care about money. They just care about having a relationship with their parent. That boy is not gonna be with you forever. That boy is here for right now. And he literally put a baby in you, and that's forever. And for any of you who are watching this video right now, you have a boyfriend and you're anywhere from the ages of 14, but yeah, I'll say 12, because this is usually when that mindset starts. Do not think that having a baby by him is gonna make him stay. I guarantee you, if anything, it's probably gonna make him leave. It's probably gonna make him leave faster. Okay, this whole glorification of being a parent is easy, being a parent is gonna make everything happy and whole, being a family is going to make everything easier. I guarantee you, probably having a child is gonna break the relationship. It's gonna make it deteriorate faster. It's gonna make everything a lot worse than you probably ever thought it ever could be. If you couldn't get along without the child, what makes you think you're gonna get along with the child? You have to make sure the situation is solid beforehand. I'm tired of the media, especially a lot of YouTubers, doing this whole glorification of teen pregnancy, this whole my routine as a teen mom, my routine as a 18-year-old mom, a 16, like, listen, I'm not saying don't showcase your life, don't tell people what you go through. I'm not saying that, but it's very weird the way a lot of women kind of glorify the lifestyle and kind of basically tell their audience that it's okay and it's such a good life to live. It's very eerie, especially when you look at the Black community. Look at all of the teen moms that we grew up watching. You got the Queen Naija, and it's weird because I'm
kind of forgot how young a lot of these people were when they had their kids. So I thought about looking into it. I'm like, oh, hell no. I was like, this is weird. Like, it's just the glorification of it all and the normalization of it all. And a lot of you may think, oh, well, it's okay. Yeah, it's okay, because at the end of the day, these people have the money to sustain these lifestyles. You don't. That's what you guys need to understand. These people are on TV. These people have social media followings that are generating income. A lot of you don't, all right? Stop doing things and looking at people and wishing to be someone and wishing to act like someone or whatever the case may be and thinking, oh, well, I could do it because they did it. Because at the end of the day, you don't have the lifestyle. You don't have the bank account. You don't. And at the end of the day, a lot of these people are not showing you the hardships behind the scenes. If you guys have not watched Unexpected, definitely go watch it. There's definitely more clips online, so you guys can definitely watch the clip. With that being said, let me know what you guys think about the clip down below. Let me know what you guys think about the normalization or the glorification of teen pregnancy and teen moms, because I think there's a lot to be said about that. I think it's really an issue, and it's just, it's really not okay. And with that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'ma see y'all next time. Make sure you guys peep the description box, comment down below, and yeah, bye.